What's going on, everybody? I'm back again with another vlog, and today I'm way south from Brooklyn, and I'm walking around Sheepshead Bay, and I'm gonna walk around the neighborhood. I've never been around here, and then I'm probably just gonna explore by the parkway and see where else can I go, maybe by the boardwalk, bro. Join me. So I got out the neighborhood, and today the weather is beautiful, and I gotta say, so far the neighborhood is pretty cool. It's pretty diverse, like a mixture of people and background walking together. So I'm gonna go deep into the main street to see what can I find. The neighborhood is pretty cool, and I'm walking around this main street, and it has like a few shops around here you can see. And if I give you like a 360, you see the subway line over there. And another thing I noticed, I guess because I'm all the way by the water, it gets a little bit like more chillier over this side. Where I live, it's a little bit warmer, but over here I feel like it's a little chilly, so I feel like it's worth it that I dress properly for the weather. But yeah, so far, you know, pretty cool. Then I'll give you what's ahead of me. Got a lot of shops, and then over there you can see like some development going on, and you got like a few markets. And I think the neighborhood little by little is changing, because I think this side over here is a little bit more affordable, but this is like a little bit far from Manhattan than the fresh food. Nice shops. It's one thing I like about neighborhoods in New York City, like the stores that you see, the local vibes, the mixture of people. Yeah, you can just walk around any neighborhood and spend like the whole day, you know. But yeah. And I think it's pretty residential and Sheepshead Bay. And it connects with a lot of neighborhoods. It connects with a lot of neighborhoods in Brooklyn. And a little bit further is Coney Island, which a lot of people, they go to Coney Island, but they never venture like around this over here, or they don't venture around Brighton Beach, which is just like a high concentration of Russians living over there. But I think it's pretty unique to go there. So yeah, talking about development, I made a little turn over here just to show you guys what I'm talking about. You can see like this new building. It looks like it's a condo for rent and stuff like that. Then over here you see like a tall skyscraper. So I guess they're trying to change the neighborhood, you know, building luxury buildings. And then you got like more apartment buildings. Then the shore parkway is over there, you know, a big parkway. And I'm gonna try to walk over that way. It's gonna be like a different vibe. Like I said, I've never been, this is my first time walking around this neighborhood, you know. I passed many times by the subway train. But yeah, I've seen pictures of it, so I thought, you know, why not come over here deep down south into Brooklyn and explore? Because I usually explore like north side of Brooklyn in the downtown, but like Brooklyn is really huge. Like I say, Brooklyn would it be its own city, would it be like one of the top four biggest cities in the United States. And then talking about local things, I think sometimes the best food, like the best local things you can find it outside Manhattan, like outside the touristy areas, like the good vibe, you know, and the cuisine. So it's always good to adventure in another area. And here I am again, passing under a highway, and a lot of blocks I pass over a highway or under a highway, but in the other side of the road is gonna be like a different vibe. Gonna be like a lake over there, a bridge across, and you're gonna end up in a residential area. So I'm here to explore it and show you guys. And as I walk around here, I made another detour to show you like the area. There's like a little park over there, so I'm just gonna cross and show you guys like a 360 view. Let me just be careful, but there you go. Let me just cross the street over here so you guys can. Probably nothing special for you guys, but cross over here, then you can see the residential areas, the condos, you know, brand new buildings, or you know, the way how they mix up the old buildings with the new buildings. They're trying to change the neighborhood, and you know, the prices go a little bit up. Then the subway line is not far, but yeah, I'm gonna continue with my walk to see the lake and show you guys. And as I walk further, since I'm getting closer to the water, it feels a little bit chilly. But over here is gonna make you feel like if you're, I don't know, somewhere else. You can start seeing the developments over here, and that's the bridge I'm talking about. So I'm gonna have to wear my hoodie and talk, because I'm getting a little cold walking around here. And then here they got like outdoor dining and some spots. I guess in the summer when the weather is perfect, this must be like a heaven area over here. Then you can see all of this over here. go up and give you like a 360 view. And they got the condos over here. So I think this is my first time walking around here, and it's a really good vibe. All I gotta say is just, wow, look at this. See a boat over here. And the peaceful water over there. And there's a bridge over there, which I'm gonna cross in a bit. And you see like apartments, a residential area over here. And this is only a few stops away from Coney Island, you know, but this is like a really awesome spot, especially when the weather gets nice. This, you know, it's like another wall over here, all the way deep south from in Brooklyn. So I'm glad that I came here. I've always wanted to come here, and now finally I got a chance to come all the way down here. So pretty worth it, you know, take a trip over here, you know, get out the beaten path and explore places that you've never been. I should have brought my safe today, but but also another good thing that I like about walking around here is that I hear a lot of people speaking foreign language. I think it's Russian, because I know there's like a highly Russian, Ukrainian population around this neighborhood. But it's mixed, you know, I see a little bit of everything, but that's what makes New York City the city that it is, you know, a unique city. So here you can see the water, a lot of birds flying around. That's a huge, like a duck over there, pretty huge. Look at this. Like I say, you know, if you guys want to get like a peaceful vibe, relaxing neighborhood, you don't have to leave New York City, because it has it all. You just got to take the subway train. Within about 30, 40 minute rides away from the hectic city, you can get places like this. And most of the times when I Google the neighborhood, this pops out over here, like this bridge over here. And you cross to another side of the neighborhood. And ahead of me is going to be Manhattan Beach. Yeah. And the people, they can ride their bike there. But yeah, like I say, it really feels like you're in another world. In another world. Look, all of this here, the condos with restaurants. People vibes. And I think there's like a university or college all the way at the end of that tip over there. But yeah, as soon as I cross the street, I'm gonna end up like in a residential area. Then maybe I'll try to make my way right, see what can I find. But I know it's gonna be like some beautiful houses ahead of me. Over here, I cross that bridge, and then this little island over here is called Manhattan Beach. It goes a little bit over that way, and then there's like a college, and then to the other side is Brighton Beach. But as you can see, it's pretty much residential. They got like some really nice, beautiful houses over here, and then I think the ocean is right ahead of me. So I'm probably just gonna walk a little forward, and then maybe I'll make a ride, or I'll figure it out. But meanwhile, look how beautiful the houses are here. Yeah, quiet residential area. Yeah, I really love the houses over here. It's so beautiful. Yeah, I'm really in love with the houses over here. At some points, it reminds me a little bit of Bay Ridge. Yeah, a lot of areas in South Brooklyn, they might share some similarities. But yeah, you can see how quiet it is over here. Like, it's a different vibe from the main street where I got off the subway stop, and within minutes away of walking, you see like another world. Like I said, it kind of reminds me a little bit of Bay Ridge, but it also reminds me a little bit of the Jersey Shore. This one, I think it's a little bit more upscale than the Jersey Shore. So here I am in another avenue called Oriental Boulevard, which I think it takes you to the college. And then I don't know if there's a park. I'm gonna walk a little forward to see what can I find. But then if I go over this way, it's gonna be Brighton Beach. So yeah, let's see what's happening over this side. So ahead of me, this is like a little park, and then there's like a little entrance, and I guess over there you can get a view of the ocean. It's pretty beautiful. It's blue, so let's check it out. And I like the sky, you know, mixed with the ocean. So let's walk forward and see what can we find. I saw a little bit of the beach, pretty beautiful, but now I'm gonna walk ahead, and then you can see like some of these houses over here. Like this one across the street is really beautiful, the house. And then when you see those apartments, that's Brighton Beach. I've never been there, you know. I passed by the subway a couple of times on my way to Coney Island, but you know, I never venture like around this side. So gonna walk over there to see what's going on. Then I also like this street side, you know, they really don't have like a, you call it like a dead end street, you know, they're pretty much like a residential area. So you go and then you just turn back, but the houses are beautiful over here. So it's like a nice summer destination to be around here. Like I said, I guess in the summertime it gets pretty packed over here. People come over here, they walk around, enjoy the beach, all of that. And then you got Rockaway Beach also in Queens. Which if you look at the map, I don't think it's really that far from here, but yeah, you know, pretty cool. So right now I'm entering Brighton Beach. And I gotta say, this area over here reminds me a little bit of the Bronx, New York. Like apartments with the shops in the first floor. Oh, sorry. Yeah, the balance, you can see the shops and everything in the first floor. So yeah, it's my first time around here. Pretty dead now, not sure if it gets busy on a regular day. Like I say, you know, a lot of apartments here, and it gets you feel like you're, I don't know, uptown. Like the Heights of the Bronx. But I heard like this neighborhood is highly Russian, you know. But yeah, if I walk over here, they got like a lot of high-rise buildings. So let me just make a little detour over here. You can see the tall buildings in the background. And then after the background, you got an ocean. So as I was walking in one of those streets, it actually takes you to the boardwalk. And I think that boardwalk connects with Coney Island. But I'm gonna walk a little forward over here to see what can I find. Like the main street, because I know you can see all the activity going on. Then the subway train passes by. And then I'll probably make a left and check out the boardwalk, because I've never been in the boardwalk of this area, but I think it's gonna be pretty interesting. Meanwhile, you can see a park over here with the apartments and people just chilling, you know, going on with their daily lives, you know. So that's pretty interesting. Over there, the GoPro Grand Super, you can see like a nice market over there. And it looks pretty busy, you know, activity going on. And the subway train is ahead of me. So this is pretty cool. And here, like you see in a lot of neighborhoods in Brooklyn and Queens, this kind of reminds me of Jackson Heights a little bit. Just for the noise. But yeah. I say it looks like Jackson Heights, but this is Brighton Beach. Famous subway line, and all the stores and all the shops. And a lot of neighborhoods like New York, you know, Queens, Brooklyn, and in the Bronx, you could get, you know, let me give you like a little view over here. So it's full of shops in the first floor, and then the subway line passes over here. So this is like all the way south of Brooklyn. And another thing I noticed as I'm walking around the street, is that I see like a lot of Russian stuff, because I say this is like heavily Russian, and a lot of stuff they have like the signs of it. So I made a little cross over here to show you guys like this. You know, I can't really read it, but anybody who speaks Russian, you can see the stores have like the Russian signs and everything. So, you know, it's gonna make the neighborhood pretty interesting. So now I'm just gonna make my turn over here, and I'm gonna explore the boardwalk. And it's nice how you have residential buildings like this right next to the boardwalk. Also love the details of this building. But so far it's been a really good walk from Sheepshead Bay all the way to Brighton Beach. So we decided to explore the boardwalk. It's been a minute since I've been by the water. Ever since last summer, I believe, or last fall. So here we are again. Let's see how can I make it over there. This is my first time in the boardwalk over here. Pretty nice. Like I said, Coney Island is over that way, but I've never been in this side. And it's like a different vibe, probably quieter, but you can see how the residential buildings are right next to the boardwalk. Then the Atlantic Ocean is over that way, but yeah. I feel like this beach is a little bit more local vibe than Coney Island. Oh, that one gets the most attention, but this one over here is pretty nice, you know. So yeah, definitely worth checking out when the weather gets better. Like I say, I love the blue sky, the water, and then there's some land over there. I believe that might be New Jersey. I know Sandy Hook's got to be somewhere around there, because I've been on the other side by Sandy Hook and I see this area over here. But yeah, I just love this blue water. It's a beautiful beach, by the way, you know, and then you see the birds and all that. I'll give you like a 360 view. So yeah, really, really cool down here in South Brooklyn. Definitely worth a visit. Like I say, really cool vibe. People just chilling over here. You got the view of the ocean. I spotted a few restaurants over there too. I guess they're like Russian restaurants. But yes, this weather's getting a little bit better. Even though it's a little bit chilly, you still see. And then I like those new buildings right ahead of me. So that was the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video of me walking around South Brooklyn. So stay tuned for more. Be safe out there, everybody. God bless y'all and peace.